Thank you for joining us. In this video, I'm going to go over some of the new shipping management features that are available in version 8.7 of liveSite. In case you're not familiar with how managing shippable products works in liveSite, I'm going to back up a little bit and I'm going to go through an order process that has a shippable product, and then I'm going to show you how you would manage an order, let's say, that needs to be shipped. So let's get started. I have a cart here and I've got a shippable product, and I'm going to go ahead and check out. And on the shipping and arrival page, I'm going to enter the destination of this package, and I'm also going to put in any special shipping instructions, and then I'm going to request the arrival date. Now, if this was a gift, I might want to select the specific date, if it's a birth date or an anniversary or something like that. I would want to put that date and make sure that it can arrive by that time. Now, one of the new features we've added is a date picker, so they can actually click and pick a date that goes in this field, and that prevents a lot of typos that sometimes happen. So I'm going to go ahead and select that I need it by April 14th. Continue checkout. So you'll see I'm looking at all the information here. It needs to get here by this date to this address, and this is what I'm shipping. So these are the options that it found that can get this product to that destination in time. I'm going to go ahead and select this, UPS 5-day ground. It's going to ask for billing information, and that's already been pre-filled because I've ordered before through the site. And now I've got my order payment preview. So I'm going to preview all of the information I have, getting ready to execute my order. A couple of new things in version 8.7. The special shipping instructions comes out both on the preview page as well as the order receipt, so the customers can see, you know, what they've entered during the checkout process. And I'm going to go ahead and purchase this. Okay, so got my order receipt and one has been emailed to me, so I'm all set there. Now, I'm already logged in as administrator, so I'm going to go and show you how the process works as far as shipping that product. So I'm going to go to my commerce tab, and I'm looking at the all orders view, which you can also access by this link here. And this view is important because we've added some new things to this view to make it more dynamic and allow you to manage the shipments that you have to send. So one of the things I wanted to show you is this thing called a shipping report. This is a brand new link in liveSite. If I click on this, I'll see a shipping report. And what this is going to do is going to show me all the products that have been ordered, and it's going to show me on what day that particular product needs to be shipped to the recipient in order to get there on time. This is really a great screen. For example, it always starts with today's date. So this would be the column I would look at if I wanted to see what I needed to ship today. And of course, I can look forward a couple of weeks to see what I need to ship in the future. And then the after the 31st, for example, after 2 weeks, these are all the products left. So it'll actually show me all the orders that have not been shipped in my site. And before works the same way. Anything before today that really needed to be shipped and hasn't been shipped will show up here. So I really probably want to take care of these first as well, if they're available. Sometimes inventory is delayed, things like that, and they're not able to be shipped on time. So these are ones that need to be looked at. All right, so this is all possible because we added a new field called a ship date to the order so that we can determine when these things need to ship. So I'm going to go ahead and look at what needs to be shipped today. If I click on that heading, it's going to take me to the all orders view. So I'm right back here. But what it did was it opened the advanced filters. So if I clicked here, that removes advanced filters. That's what that view looks like normally. But it's going to open the advanced filters. And the other thing it's going to do is it's going to set the date range, not by the order date, but by the ship date. So it's showing me March 18th, March 18th, which is today. So it just basically set these filters for me. It also set this new status we have for orders called shipping status. So it's setting that to unshipped. So these are all the orders that need to ship today that have not been shipped, basically. And you'll see there's really only one that I need to ship today. So if I went back, just show you where that is. Again, if I went back to the shipping report, right here, these two products, these right here, really actually came from one order. They could have come from multiple orders, but these two products need to be shipped today. So again, if I click on this heading, it's going to take me to all orders report and filtered by today's ship date. So here's the order. And if I looked at the order in detail, you'll see that there are the two products that came from my shipping report that need to be shipped. You'll see there's no shipping quantity, so they haven't been shipped yet. and you'll see the ship date is today. And again, if you need to postpone a shipment or something like that, you can always change the ship date at any time. It'll move it on that shipping report. All right, so let's say that I need to go ahead and export all this data for my shipping software. Let's just go back out of this screen. If I wanted to, I would just export using either export button here to export the orders. It'll export all the order data. If there's one or more, export all that information to a CSV file that I can then use to import into my shipping software. Now, we added another feature too to liveSite in version 8.7. When you export your orders, it's going to change the order status here from complete to exported. Now, that's important, so I'm not going to click this button because it's actually going to do that to this order. But if you click the button, it's going to show that as exported. Now, that's really nice because if you have a lot of orders happening through your site, you need to be able to take a look at which orders have been completed and which ones have been exported. So you can kind of see what's been moved out of liveSite into, let's say, your shipping management software. And we've added a status for that. So you can look at everything that's complete. I'm going to go ahead and set this range here to the whole year. Everything that's complete, and you could also look at everything that is exported. So you can see I have not exported any orders, but in a course of a real operation, you would have exported orders as you're shipping things every day or as you're exporting them to your shipping software. So this lets you know what has been moved outside of the system and what is still, you know, being handled here in liveSite. So it's a good idea if you're not sure or you don't see an order that you think you should see. You should always kind of use the completed or exported view because then you can see both. All right, so let's go back to the shipping report and we're going to go back to today and we'll go back to that order here that needs to be shipped. Now, if I have shipped this, let's say I've exported to my shipping software and I've set it all up and it's going to be shipped. One thing that I'm going to want to probably do is print a packing slip for this. If I click on that, it's going to give me a packing slip here. And a couple things we added to the packing slip in version 8.7 of liveSite is there's a shipping method that's been added, as well as if there's any kind of product form with any kind of information there, we attach that as well. Now in this particular order, they did not select a color, which was optional, but if they had, that information would show up here as well as any other fields that they might have asked for the products. Okay, so you probably want to print that. If you need to print it, you can print it here. If your shipping software prints it, that's great too. And let's say that I'm going to go ahead and have this order picked up and I've got tracking numbers now. So if I put a tracking number in here, and this is just a bogus number, I would put the tracking codes in here and I would mark these as shipped so that I'm telling liveSite's been shipped, and I would save that. All right, so let's remove the advanced filters and let's take a look at all completed orders by the year. And a couple things I want to show you here is here's the order we were just manipulating right here. You'll notice that there's a couple of trucks here and those are added whenever a tracking code is entered. So this gives you the understanding that, you know, these things are on their way, basically. Gives you a quick visual identification of that. And if you were to click on one of these trucks, it would actually launch the UPS website or whatever and show you the status of that. So it's real easy to manage your shipments here and make sure that they made it to their destination. All right, I believe that's pretty much all the new items for version 8.7. And from this process, you can actually manage all of your shippable orders within liveSite. And there's not a tight process here. So if your shipping process is a little bit more flexible, we tried to make that flexible by just adding statuses and different kinds of views so that you could kind of create your own process that works for you. So hopefully you find this useful and we do appreciate you watching the video. Thank you.